I got my hands on the OnePlus X, the budget smartphone from the company OnePlus. I initially wasn't going to make a durability video for this phone, because I didn't think it would be fair to compare a $250 budget phone alongside $700 flagship devices. But between the YouTube comments and my Twitter followers, I was convinced to give it a shot, and I'm glad I did. Let's start with the scratch test. If you've seen my other videos, you are familiar with Mohs scale of hardness, and the picks that I have that let me know what level of hardness the glass has. The OnePlus X is rocking Gorilla Glass 3. It also has a screen protector included and pre-installed on the phone. I forgot about this minor detail and was very surprised when the screen started scratching at a level 4. But let's remove that plastic screen protector and try the test again. You can see that my picks leave no mark up until level 6. 6 left a minor scratch, and 7 left a much deeper groove. This is exactly on par with other smartphones that have Gorilla Glass 4, like the Nexus 6P and the BlackBerry Priv. A razor blade could do a little bit of damage, but you'll have no problem with keys or coins scratching your screen. The back is made of the same exact material, and scratches on the same level as the front glass. A small scratch at level 6, and a larger scratch at level 7. So far the phone is doing pretty well. While we are scratching things, let's scuff up the camera lens. The camera lens is independent of the back glass panel. You can see it move around inside its little circle as I scratch it with my razor blade. The lens is scratch resistant, which is awesome. A scratched up camera lens would absolutely ruin picture quality. Props to OnePlus for protecting their camera. The $700 BlackBerry Priv did not have a scratch proof camera lens. Thumbs up if you like taking clear pictures. Let's move on to the extreme heat test. I've tested 10 different phones now with this lighter, and every single phone has survived unscathed except the Nexus 6P. The Nexus 6P's pixels turned white and never recovered. The same thing is now happening to the OnePlus X. The AMOLED pixels turn white and never recover. This particular background hides the damage pretty well, so let me switch it to a plain black background so you can see the permanent damage. Now, I'm not going to say that the Nexus 6P used a budget AMOLED screen, but I will say that the 6P screen is very comparable to the budget AMOLED screen of the OnePlus X. But let's be honest, don't start a fire on top of your device and you'll be just fine. The metal sides of the OnePlus X feel very good in your hands. It is relatively soft though, so be careful when your phone is around razor blades and keys. Onto the bin test. I'll be honest, I was 100% expecting this phone to break. But after the initial flex, it locks out and will not let the phone bend any farther. There are no weak points. If you'll watch my teardown of the OnePlus X, you'll see that each section of the phone, like the motherboard and battery and charging port, all have their own little compartment inside of the metal frame, which allows the front glass, motherboard, and battery to all add structural integrity to the phone, making it unbendable. I am very impressed with this device. It is awesome that such an inexpensive phone can be more durable than a device that costs 2 or 3 times as much. Thanks for talking me into testing this device. Follow me on Twitter for updates on videos while I am filming them, if you are into that kind of thing. Hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, and I hope to see you around. Thanks for watching.